is one of the diagnostic cases in this module here. And so the goal is to come into the glenohumeral joint and do the full diagnostic arthroscopy, but in doing so, you actually are looking for any related pathology. Now, in sort of in real life, right, we would have examined the patient, we would have the history, and we would have the associated imaging. So we go into these cases really already having a good idea of what we expect to find and what we're going to do. So I have I'm viewing from the posterior portal. I have the probe in the anterior portal, which is really situated between the biceps and the subscap. And so we see the long head of the biceps there at the front of our screen. And so my probe is just, the back of the probe is touching the biceps. And then the humeral head is to my right. The glenoid is on the bottom of the screen there. So then I'm looking at the bottom down, sort of the anterior inferior aspect of the shoulder. This is the middle glenohumeral ligament sitting on top of the subscapularis tendon. So the probe is right through the subscap right there. And then we can see the labrum. And so here, so hard, the simulator is great. Obviously, it doesn't necessarily completely replicate what you're going to see intraoperatively. But the labrum here, it does feel a little bit loose. And so then we're seeing now the most inferior aspect of the labrum. So that's the inferior labrum. You can see the humeral head is above us, the glenoid is below us. And then just kind of some fraying on the undersurface of the rotator cuff. That I'm looking up at the supraspinatus tendon, so that's above us. Right here, the probe is touching the supraspinatus tendon. And then I'm gonna shift my eyes a little bit. I'm looking at where the rotator cuff attaches to the humeral head. So let's see if we can get our probe up there too. So there's where the rotator cuff attaches to the rotator cuff footprint. And I'm looking all the way at the back there. But so no obvious rotator cuff tear, just some fraying on the undersurface of the rotator cuff. There's our biceps where it attaches to the superior labrum. And I'm gonna shift my eyes a little bit to look directly at the superior labrum. The biceps itself looks good, but the anterior labrum is definitely loose. So I'd say this patient has a Bankart lesion, which is a tear of the anterior inferior labrum associated with shoulder instability. Otherwise, the rest of the joint looks good.